So with regards to the COVIDSafe app, I mean, can't we just replace any identifying information with random identifiers and that would effectively make all the data anonymous?
Yeah, so IDs are really important in contact tracing. IDs are used in COVIDSafe to notify the government of the contacts you've had so that when you're infected, the government can notify them. The IDs in COVIDSafe look random, but because they come from government, the government can sort of learn who you've come into contact with. And so there's kind of no privacy in that sense. Mm-hmm. And the government absolutely knows that the kinds of people you come into contact with. So it doesn't preserve privacy in that sense at the moment, but producing random IDs is the realm of decentralized approaches.
Okay, so I mean, let's talk a little bit about decentralized approaches. I mean, what's the difference between decentralized and centralized, and why are so many privacy advocates saying we should have adopted a decentralized model?
Yeah, so really the key difference is who generates the IDs and when they're shared and how they're shared. So in COVIDSafe, when you're infected with COVID, you test positive, you share the IDs you've seen with government. Mm-hmm. And so that means that the government or the central authority or Amazon who's running the server learns of your contacts. But in the decentralized approach, your phone generates the random IDs. And if you're infected, you share the IDs you've sent rather than the IDs you've seen. So that means you're not revealing anything about your contacts. And people can periodically look at the web page and see what IDs have been shared to figure out whether you've come into contact with anyone.
Right. Okay. And so, I mean, in your opinion, what are the sort of pros and cons of the current COVIDSafe app that we're out there, that's out?
Yeah. So, well, I think it's, automatic contact tracing is definitely a promising assistance for manual contact tracing. Mm-hmm. That's what the medical professionals are saying. An advantage of COVIDSafe that comes from Trace Together, the Singapore app, is that it uses Bluetooth proximity instead of location data. Mm-hmm. Location data is extremely privacy sensitive, as you know from our Mikey work, for example, from about a year ago. But Bluetooth proximity is a little bit less sensitive potentially. So that's an advantage. There are some disadvantages with COVIDSafe with the way it's implemented. So one, as we discussed, is that it's centralized and not decentralized. Mm-hmm. And experts do think that a decentralized modification of COVIDSafe would be quite possible. Mm-hmm. Also, there are some sort of nuances, like it shares phone make and model when you come in contact with someone, so that you can interpret signal strength appropriately. Mm-hmm. Because different phones' signal strength means proximity to different degrees. But that information that's shared isn't encrypted, so it makes it easier to fingerprint people.
Mm. Right, so they could have made some very small changes and to make this a little bit better.
Yeah, I think that's the idea. So I think, you know, it's definitely could be worse, but it could be better too. And, you know, I think it's also important to say it's unlikely that perfect privacy would be possible with automatic contact tracing. But, you know, it's good to consider how to make privacy as strong as possible.